Are you frustrated with the limitations of manual data entry and outdated systems in your business? With SOTI Snap, you can empower delivery drivers to confirm the delivery of items within a retail industry app. Let's design an interface where drivers can seamlessly update delivery statuses for items that they've delivered. To achieve this, we'll leverage a REST service endpoint to communicate delivery details, which can then be seamlessly integrated with the app widgets. Hi, I'm Shash, SOTI's SVP of Product Strategy. In this video, I will guide you through the process of using REST APIs to automate data transfer between your systems within minutes, all using SOTI Snap. Here's an app that allows Rocket Co.'s delivery drivers to confirm and document their deliveries. Let's take a quick look at the experience. The delivery driver selects the item for delivery, and the invoice and costs are automatically populated from the connected inventory database. The driver then adds details, captures a signature and a related set of images, and then they complete the delivery of each item. Today, we'll demonstrate how this app can seamlessly connect to existing databases using REST data connections and thus simplifying employee processes. Let's get started. Rocket Co. uses this delivery confirmation app where the drivers manually enter each delivery item, invoice, and cost. It would be beneficial to integrate the app with Rocket Co.'s inventory management database to streamline this process. This integration would allow the app to retrieve information about the item scheduled for delivery, enabling it to automatically populate the corresponding details once the driver selects the items. There are two parts to this objective. First, to gather all the items for delivery to populate the dropdown, and second, to populate the data for a selected item in the dropdown. The inventory management system has API endpoints defined for its database. This allows the data from the inventory management system to seamlessly flow to any third-party applications or systems. We can use these endpoints to retrieve data for invoices, costs, and item names, all with REST-based API calls. For the first part, navigate to the Data Connection Rules tab. Select the REST API section and click Create New REST API Rule. Provide a name for the REST API endpoint, such as Update Delivery Items Details. Choose the REST service as the source and proceed. First, you need to specify the request details, such as the information required to update the delivery status. To create the REST connection, you should provide the name and base URL obtained from the inventory system. If the inventory database's endpoints require authentication, enable it and input the REST service credentials. In the next window, configure all the details. Change the command to GET because the app needs to retrieve details from the inventory database. In the request details, input the key value pairs for the headers, body, and query strings as appropriate. In our case, it's delivery item's name, invoice number, and cost of the item. After entering the details, click Test Connection and verify the functionality by testing the API. Subsequently, input any path parameters required for the request, if applicable. Once done, review the response parameters and the data received from the REST service call. This step is crucial for mapping the response parameters with app widgets. Select the fields relevant for mapping with app widgets, ensuring that all necessary data is accessible. Once you're satisfied with the settings, finalize the data connection. The newly created REST service will appear in the respective widget actions or data sources. Now let's integrate this data connection into the app interface. Navigate to the app page and go to the Events tab. Select Onload actions and choose Invoke REST API to invoke the REST service upon selecting an item name. Click Map Fields to map the app fields with the REST API parameters. Map the response parameters to the app fields as shown. This action will populate all the items for delivery in the Delivery Items dropdown. Once all mappings are set, click Save. You can now preview the app to verify the functionality. The second objective is to retrieve the corresponding data when the driver selects the items. To do this, we will create an additional REST API connection to fetch item data. Let's call this connection Get Item Details. When setting up the REST API service, choose Get. Since we need to retrieve the details of the selected item, in the request details, we have headers, body, and query string. Since we need to obtain details for the selected item, we'll use a query string to retrieve the correct item details. Enter item name in the key field for query strings. The response details will display all the data that will be received for any selected item. Testing the connection will ensure the API accurately returns the relevant invoice and cost information for the selected items. Once done, save the data connection. In our case, both data connections are configured as GET commands. You can also use POST or other commands to display the values in a table format based on the demands of your app. Then, in the form page, select the dropdown and navigate to Events to invoke the REST API. Invoke the newly created data connection and proceed to map the fields Invoice and Cost to complete the configuration. The mapping step is crucial to ensure that the corresponding data for invoice and cost are reflected in the app when the driver chooses the item name from the dropdown. Click Save, and upon previewing, you'll see that once an item is selected, the invoice and cost are automatically updated. Okay, let's save and publish the app to see it in action. With this setup, delivery drivers can efficiently update delivery statuses within a retail industry app, thereby improving efficiency and customer satisfaction. And that's it! In just a few minutes, we created an app to automate data collection from connected databases through a REST service, which significantly increases Rocket Co's efficiency. Thanks for tuning in. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for the latest updates if you find our content valuable. To learn more about the SOTI One platform and how it makes mobile-first business operations simple, efficient, and reliable, visit soti.net.